up, Mr. Anderson here. Welcome to my crib. So I got a pretty cozy apartment here. The main HQ right there, there's the desk where things get done. IKEA, that's where I got that desk. I assembled it myself. I kind of screwed up the drawers. I'm not gonna show you that because I'm embarrassed about it. Hey, we got the bookshelf here. I organized my bookshelf the other day by author last name, because that's what you do when you're in quarantine. So we're outside on the balcony. It's a beautiful day. It's wonderful. The other side of my shoulder here, I don't know if you can see it right there. We got the Capitol. The Capitol building is just more blocks away. So, got my TV. I haven't been doing that much Netflix. I've been working, been grinding. Put a little FIFA on the weekends to relax, blow off some steam. I got my little My Career, My Player. He's thriving right now. Thanks for asking. The couch is a place for relaxation. The kitchen, this is where the real magic happens. Quarantine fridge. That's the big thing, is LaCroix. Greens. Most important is the Ben & Jerry's. Got my Annie's, granola bars. Bathroom's over here. I'm not gonna show you the bathroom because it is the bathroom. No one wants to see that. That's my crib. So hope you enjoyed this tour. Hope everyone is staying safe during the quarantine. Stay productive, stay active. I'm not, cooped up in here. Again, I'm getting out, going for a walk, I'm doing my thing. But yeah, hope to be back at CB sooner rather than later. So thanks for hanging out in my crib. Later.
Oh, hey there. Quarantine has changed all our routines, so I guess I'll show you mine. My day typically starts with me doing my homework and doing my assignments, and then I feed my fish. Even though quarantine has ruined a lot of things, especially my favorite thing, shopping, I still find a way through online shopping to get the clothes I like and to get dressed for the day. This is my home gym, my favorite part of my quarantine routine. Once I'm done with the workout, my fun activities can actually start. This is my way of relaxing after a hard workout. I love to get out in the outdoors. I'm so grateful for my CB experience and the friends I've made along the way.
Hey, what's up, CB?
Just here, just to show off my my morning grind. So what I do is I wake up, okay, and then I just go straight after that, straight to my important business. So here is my my office space, yeah, and right there, that's my important business. I do that every single day, and and when I want to have fun, I play the piano. All right, well, anyway, so I just want to say I miss you all you guys. Yeah, it's really weird staying at home and in quarantine. I also miss all my teachers, and they've, done a lot to, get us where we are, and just want to say I'm very grateful for all the teachers that we have at CB. They're all very supportive, and they're amazing people. Thank you, guys.
Oh, hi! I'm Mr. Boom. Welcome. Welcome to an edition of Quarantine Cribs. I'd like to show you my house. Come on in. This is one of my workspaces. This is my grand piano. It's a Sony 1924. I'll do things that are not always for Christian Brothers High School. I'll do some recording, a composition. Right now I'm working on some music for our music circus for the summer. And this is where I'll come read an important book. Think about the things in life that are important. What are the things that I think about? What are the upsides of this quarantine? Well, I get to think a lot. I get to appreciate the people in my life who I love and who I appreciate. And I get to take walks with my furry friends, which we're gonna talk about in a minute. And these two guys we get to walk with almost every day. If it's not raining, they love to walk. This is Louie, that's Stella. Good boy, Louie. And they're good walkers. And then at the end of the day, if I'm tired, I just want to be done working. No more assignments, no more music. I just want to spend some downtime out to my cabana, put on my sunglasses, give the dogs a treat. Sit. Good girl. Put on my sunglasses, relax, and say goodbye to another day.
I'm Lulu, as you know. So currently it's 2:22 in the morning.
That's just like my makeup area. That's Sydney's toothbrush in case she wants to come over and just hang out.
And when I'm not at my desk, I'm here with Elvis.
So naturally, I'm hungry at this hour. A grilled cheese, peanut butter, and jelly sandwich without the cheese. Because, you know, whatever's my tummy. Usually I'm like awake till like 5:30, 6:30. I don't know, trying to get sleep. And then I like wake up for class around like 9:30. I roll my sleeves up. I have to get sticky. I like to roller skate. My favorite class during quarantine is probably cat. I like to take my cat outside. Come on, what was I saying? There's really not much special. I kind of just spend most of my day in my room. I feel like quarantine has made me, what's the word? Mellow.
No, that's my word.
More relaxed. No, unmotivated. This is literally all I do. Like the most I've done, well, I mean, I messed up the plumbing system if that counts as something. So that was fun. I talked to myself a lot more. Really thankful for my friends, because they're definitely keeping me sane through it. Semi-sane. Eh, I'm bored. No spider. I have a pogo stick, but I can't use it in the house anymore. I just want to say thank you to everyone at CB, especially my teachers and counselors and friends and family, for showing me so much love throughout these 4 years and for encouraging me to grow into the person I am today. Sending my love. Bye.
Oh. Hey, CB. Welcome to my quarantine crib. Come on in. This is my quarantine crib. This is where it all goes down. From watching movies to listening to music to studying. So I'll take you on over to the study table. Come on. So this is where it happens. This is where I take my Zoom calls, do my homework, submit my homework, take tests. This is the magic, baby. But on a more serious note, I just wanted to say thank you to the whole class of 2020, to all of CB in general. It's been an amazing 4 years. I've had a really great time. I've made a bunch of amazing friends, the boys. You know who you are. K79G3, much love. Thank you to both my classmates and my teachers for making this amazing.
Oh, hi. Welcome to my quarantine crib. Come on in. So this is the Spinelli household. I am quarantined with my lovely husband who's filming and my two wonderful daughters. Oh, you made me a poster. That's lovely. Thank you.
We can do pretend.
Absolutely, this whole thing is pretend. And come on into our kitchen. We have turned the popcorn maker. It's now a permanent station on the counter during quarantine. Popcorn is a big deal around here. And actually the bigger deal is my husband's been working on and perfecting the pizza dough recipe, so that has been pretty awesome. So yeah, I can show you a couple of our big pieces of heirloom furniture. I have this cross stitch that my grandmother made, which is pretty awesome. I'm glad that I inherited that. This will probably be Christina's one day as she gets older. And then over here is our other piece of heirloom furniture. You may not recognize this. This is from actually the year you were born. I looked it up. So yeah, this is where I've been teaching lessons for Christina. I have been working, the computer's closed right now because Schoology's down, and I'm hoping Buddy Christ does this thing for Schoology. So we will see. Good luck. And yeah, I think that's it. Welcome to our quarantine crib. Bye.
I don't want to get up.
Well, I got up by around 8. I already did my homework, so that's done. Now we need to eat food, eggs, milk, bananas.
Okay.
Nah. Better.
Well, you're probably like, Denny Buck Buck. Where's your chair? Dog.
Well, I assume I gained a few pounds, considering I just snapped it in half.
So now I do my homework without a chair. Just sitting down, I mean, I can still see.
And bada boom. Yeah, that's the pond I get to see every day when I run.
What? Look at them. They had 8 babies. What?
That thing's cool.
So, well, that's the end. After that, I usually just eat and just go to bed. Ever seen Groundhog's Day? Watch that movie. It's pretty good. It's about a groundhog. Well, now, I go to bed.
Welcome to my quarantine crib. Come on in.
So some days when I'm cooped up inside, I like to sit in my comfy chair, get a little bit of work done, catch up on some HGTV, hang out with the dog and the daughter.
This is where Oliver comes for his daily massage. He has a very rough life. I kind of want his life, actually.
I think the things that I am missing the most, probably my daily routine, and I never thought I would say this, but actually going into Christian Brothers, some of you know that I have a really long commute and I'm always complaining about it. but these days I definitely would really cherish getting in my car and driving to campus. And of course I'm missing all of the students and my office and my colleagues and the work that I'm used to doing. And now I'm having to do it in a different kind of a way. Some of the things I think that this is teaching us is that I think it's really helping us to know how strong we are, and that true character of our strength and what's really important is coming out.
Hey guys, it's me, David, and I just want to show you guys my daily quarantine routine. Come on in. And so this is my workspace, you know. I wake up at 9, just lay in bed. When I gotta do my Zoom calls, here's my work chair, my iPad, you know. Right here, we just stay grinding, and let me show you the rest of my day. All right, so at around noontime, you know, 1 or 2, usually come out here, do yard work. Me and my dad been out here lately. Later tonight we're gonna take out the cement probably, and if I'm not doing that, I usually just come out here chill with my dogs. Hey, Smiles! Alright, well that's Smiles over there. Hey, Molly. That's my homie, Molly. Hey, Molly, say what's up. That's my class right there. That's my class. But yeah, and after that I probably go on a bike ride. Come on, let's go. After my 30 or 40 mile bike ride, usually just come home and just chill with the family and, you know, just stay grinding on my schoolwork. Let's go. And lastly, I just like to say thank you to the class of 2020 at Christian Brothers for make me a more well-rounded person for all the memories that I made with you guys. And I'm just happy I made a lot of friends, some good people.
While we've been stuck in our quarantine crib, the Greco twins have had a lot of time to think about what we're grateful for at CB.
We love our teachers.
For St. John Baptiste de La Salle.
For Kairos.
Our lovely friends who still get together to play quarantine Pictionary.
For our CB sports teams.
For band.
For our CB campus.
For our staff and administration.
It's hard to pick one thing. It's just the CB experience.
Hello, and welcome to my quarantine crib. As you can see, I've got the sweet little corner of my home to get my work done every day. Well, after working out in the morning, and I love to shower, get dressed, and jump right in here to get my work done. As you can see, I've got pretty much everything I need right here within arm's reach. I think it's important to combine our work with our relaxation. I find myself taking a lot of breaks throughout the day. And now as a family, we've been putting together puzzles and doing art projects, doing a lot of reading, cooking, baking, watching some great movies too. But certainly the best part of all of this quarantine is the incredible gift of time. You know, while digital learning has its own challenges and rigors, I don't have a daily commute. I have fewer meetings and a flexible daily schedule, and a lot more time for myself and my family. Well, the worst part of my chosen workspace is pruny fingers and toes. And I certainly do miss all the face-to-face human interaction with my students and colleagues. I even miss giving out dress code slips. I keep them close by just in case. I tried giving them to my family, but they just don't have the same impact. Well, thanks for dropping in. I hope to see you guys back at school someday.
Okay, so I usually wake up at 11 in the morning to start my homework, and my mom wants us to be all at the same table so she knows that we're doing our work. So she made us put blue tape on the table a couple weeks ago because we were all fighting over space on the table, so now we evenly have our own equal space now, so we know not to move into each other's space. So my mom usually works at this spot right here. I do my homework right here. I have like my computer, my iPad, and all that stuff. After I do homework and stay inside for a little bit, I'll come out here, play some volleyball, jump on my trampoline. I'll pick the oranges from the orange tree. Sometimes I'll take a walk. At CB, I'm most grateful for all my friends and all my teachers and just being able to have the opportunity to make so many memories that I'm gonna remember forever. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it.
What's up, seniors? It's Nick, and I was asked to give you a daily life of what I have been doing in quarantine. Here it is. After I get some schoolwork in, I usually end up coming out here and making some coffee. While my coffee's brewing, I'm gonna go do some laundry I have to get done because one thing that I've been doing a lot during this quarantine is going into work. I still have to go to work because I am a line cook. So I've been going in probably like four or five days a week or so, working night shift. I gotta clean my mask in the laundry because I have to wear this mask that my mom's friend made to, like, every shift because, you know, Corona. So that's pretty much like all what my life's been lately. Just work, school, and music in my free time. Quarantine's been pretty tough on me, but, and I'm sure it's the same for everybody else, but we're a strong class. And I just wanna wish all of you the best of luck with whatever you're doing. Yeah, thank you. Love you, CB.
Hey, CB seniors, class of 2020. This is my casa, and this is where my COVID-19 quarantine is happening. So follow me and I'll give you guys a quick tour. Most of my time is spent down here in my favorite room of the house, the basement. So come on down. As you can see, it's pretty much got everything. I wanna focus a little bit more on some great artwork that I got. This is from Polo Lopez, class of 08. Painted this for me. Over here, I've got my Sacramento Corner artwork, represented by Cake and Tesla, two Sacramento bands. This is artwork from concerts that I have attended over the years. Got Los Lonely Boys, Stone Temple Pilots, The Black Crowes, Prince, of course, Santana and Maná, Led Zeppelin. Wish I would have attended that one, but did not. Guns N' Roses and Metallica over here. And then if I get bored, of course, I've got a nice selection of electric and acoustic guitars and a banjo down here. And yeah, this is where I hang out for most of my COVID quarantine. I'd just like to say, class of 2020, you guys got a raw deal on your last quarter of your senior year, and I'm really sorry about that. You really didn't deserve this, and you guys deserve much, much more. But just with that being said, know that I love you. We love you at CB, and we wish you all the best in the future. I hope you guys enjoyed the little tour, and be well.
What's up? It's your girl, Katrine. Some of you may know me, and some of you may not. But just vibe with me as I show you a piece of Tongan culture. I thought this song would be nice to share because it might resonate with how many of us are feeling as we leave CB to embark on a new journey in life. I would like to give a big shout out to my friends that have been there for me for all 4 years and have helped me confide more in myself. Another shout out goes to all the teachers that have had me in their classrooms. I'm so grateful to have met so many great people who have taught me that learning doesn't stop in the classroom. Thank you, Christian Brothers, for showing me to love my culture and that Kairos exists to let students reflect on themselves. I might as well end my part with a Tongan saying, Fayaki ilo, owa e fayaki e fanongo. Do it by knowing, not by hearing.
What I'm most grateful for at CB is the community. All the teachers, all your friends, everyone really cares about you. I wouldn't imagine that 4 years ago that I'd turn into like such a weird person, thanks to like all my friends and teachers that helped me develop into a new person, I guess. And I'm just really thankful for that. Well, this is my room. There's nothing really in my room. I have a guitar. I'm not really good at guitar, and I have a computer over there, which I do my homework on. And I guess that's it. See ya.
Hey! Okay, Zoe. Let's put on the box. Hey, B!
Knew this day would come, we'd be standing one by one with our future in our hands. So many dreams, so many plans. Always knew after all these years there'd be laughter, there'd be tears, but never thought I'd walk away with so much joy but so much pain. And it's so
all right, welcome to the Cribs at Christian Brothers High School. Yep, checking out the Cribs. This is the back of the room. This is where I sit when I'm not in the front of the room. But usually when I'm in the front of the room, there's the special podium that I don't use in my crib. This is Miss Spinelli's desk. It's awesome. As awesome as she is a teacher. Let's see, here we go. This is what I get to look at. Every day, from right to left, from left to right, which is the exact, I think that's the opposite of what you guys see. Or, well, I'm trying to sync it up, is what I'm saying. Anyway, this is my crib. This is the coolest place in the world, right here. And all those desks were talking to me, and they are missing you guys, but they want you to be happy and healthy, just like me. Especially you seniors. You guys take care of one another out there. All right, Mr. Hayes' crib. Oh, you want to know where I sleep? Right there. All right, you guys take care. Have a good day. Crib's out from Mr. Hayes.